Hello, 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 humanity. Sorry about that. I made a dish a occasional treat, not something that we should indulge in on a regular basis. There's quite a bit of potatoes. They turn into starch, and then we don't want to do a lot of deep fried cooking as well. Well, anyway, I want to share this quick tasty recipe with you. It truly is it's tasty, tasty as well as affordable, very convenient. It was real easy to fix, and I really liked it, humanity. But like I said, it's just something for the holidays that give you a little versatility with the starch that turns into sugar. That's not something that I would recommend that you eat on a regular basis. I am going to try later on tonight to bring you a slightly healthier version, one where the mashed potatoes are made out of cauliflower, and you still wouldn't want to eat a lot of deep fried foods all the time, but at least it would give you a more healthier alternative to the potatoes. So anyway, getting right to it, all I did was I happened to I hope that you would make your mashed potatoes from scratch. Had I not been aching, I would have. But I got a couple of packs of the mashed potatoes. Well, all you have to do, you only need boil your water, and then take the potato packets and then empty them over into the boiling water. And stir, and then you have your potatoes, and then you'll put that to the side. And after you put that to the side, I had I really can't remember the name offhand, the name of the fish fry, but I'll try to bring it to you. And so you'll get your fish fry seasoning and put it to the side, and you literally don't need anything else except the mashed potatoes and the fish fry, and of course your oil to deep fry your mashed potatoes. And I take that back. And then you'll need maybe two to three big leaves of collard greens, because I did one batch of deep fried mashed potatoes with collard greens, and then another one I did without collard greens. So this is all I did, humanity. I just took maybe what you would consider maybe a teaspoon scoop of the mashed potatoes, rolled it around in the fish seasoning, and of course you would use maybe between a half of a cup and or a cup of oil, and let it get hot. And after you take all of the mashed potato mixture and roll it into the fish seasoning, then you'll put the little balls. I use the shape of a ball, maybe about marble size, and then I just place those over into the hot oil. You'll let them brown on both sides, maybe from 3 to 5 minutes, and then after I completed one batch, then I reserved some of the mashed potatoes, and I took two leaves, and I tossed them over in the oil. But I wouldn't recommend that you do that. You can get the same results from damping the collard greens and chopping them or splitting them in half and throwing it in the air fryer for maybe about 3 minutes. I think that would be a little bit healthier. And then all I did was just insert one or two of the chopped collard greens, chopped to maybe about the size of half of a teaspoon, and place that into the mashed potato, formed a ball, rolled it in the fish seasoning, and then fried that as well, 3 to 5 minutes on each side. And they really are tasty, the deep fried mashed potato balls, humanity. I'm going to try to bring you a healthier version. I'm going to try the cauliflower, making the mashed potatoes into cauliflower. And then bringing that to you, telling you how that turned out. Okay, humanity, you know how we do it. I'm going to go and get it and then bring it back to you. Okay, take care.